should be able to hear it.
Okay.
Well, I mean, not in a room, but you should. Ladies.
peaceful dawn. Teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father. You were chosen for the Son.
Well, we could do something like if we get here. That's, I don't know, that's pretty short, but if we got here, you could just give me a sign and then I can just end it either like on that chord or play a little bit more and finish it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we could end right there, actually. That would be good if that worked out.
You guys
that
could really end this anywhere.
Actually, I mean, if you're going to go beyond that, you might as well sing that whole phrase because that's really short. But it might be kind of cool just to stop it right there if it works that way.
Yeah. Dave.
Thank you.
Good evening, Happy New Year, and welcome to St. Henry Church. This evening, we celebrate the Solemnity of Mary, the Holy Mother of God. Presiding this evening is Father Jeshua and Father Shinto. They will be assisted by Diaconate Candidate Rick DeBusk. Our readings can be found at the hymnals at number 877. Please stand and join us in singing our gathering hymn number 308, Angels We Have Heard on High, number 308.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing all the plains and the mountains in reply, echo back their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
The Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, as the year 2022 ends and as we are ready to enter the new year, we need to be more joyful, more happy, because we have entered the year 2022. We know we have been so happy, sometimes we have a lot of difficulties in our lives. But let the new year, 2023, be a year of joy, happiness, and peace to all of us. As we have gathered here, let us recall to our minds the sins that we have committed the year 2022 and ask for God's pardon and mercy so that we can participate in this Holy Mass in an worthy manner. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you. You.
Through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary, bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her, through whom we were found worthy to receive the order of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that we are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord. My dear sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, today there is no printout because our printing machine is out of order. Spain is known for its national sport called bullfighting. A mother was crying while watching the bullfighting. The person seated next to her was a priest and was wondering why this woman was crying. He asked her, "Why are you crying?" "I am afraid that the bull would kill my son. But I pray to God, Father, that my son will be spared and win the fight," answered the mother. "Don't be afraid, madam," said the priest. "I am sure your son will win and kill the bull," continued the priest. "How sure are you, father, that my son will win and kill the bull?" asked the mother. "It's very easy, ma'am, because the bull doesn't have a mother who prays for his safety and victory. unlike your son, he has a mother praying for him, and that is you," answered the priest. As we start the new year, we celebrate the solemnity of Mary, the Mother of God, thus reminding us of our other mother, Mother Mary. As Jewish proverb puts it succinctly, God cannot be everywhere, so he created mothers. As we commemorate this solemn feast, the Church has for us these brief reminders. In the year 431 AD, the Council of Ephesus, an ecumenical council of bishops of the Catholic Church, settled whether Mary is to be called Mother of Christ, Christotokos, implying Jesus is merely human, or Mother of God, Theotokos. The council decided on the title Theotokos, Mother of God, for Mary. The council said Mary is rightfully the Mother of God, therefore affirmed the divinity of Christ. Even in the Bible, the first person who refers Mary as the Mother of God is her cousin Elizabeth, who said in a loud voice, "Who am I that the mother of my Lord should come to me?" So don't worry about the title. Some people are worried whether we should call Mary Mother of God or Mother of Christ. Don't worry. Elizabeth had the dare to call. Why can't we have that dare? So there is nothing wrong with invoking Mary with the title Mother of God. What do we mean when we invoke Mary as Mother of God? When we say Mary is the Mother of God, we do not mean that from all eternity, our God took his Godship from Mary, or that Mary is the source of the Godship of Jesus. As the Catholic Church teaches us that Jesus Christ was eternally begotten by God, light from light, true God from true God, eternally begotten by the Father. It means that Mary did not give Jesus Christ his Godship. Mary only gave birth Jesus Christ his humanity. However, right from the moment of conception, the baby in the womb of Mary was truly God and truly man at the same time. Therefore, the baby born from the womb of Mary is God and man. Mary gave birth to God and man. When we say Mary is the Mother of God, it does not mean that she gave Godship to Jesus. It only means that Jesus was God right from her womb. If we only call Mary as the Mother of Christ, that means Jesus was not divine when he was in her womb. So it's always good to call Mary Mother of God, because at the very moment of conception, in the womb of Mary, Jesus was God. So she was also carrying God, the Son. If we look at the attitude of a mother, we realize the beauty of motherhood. At the start, when she still bore the child in her womb, she has to take care of herself in order that the child would not be in danger. She could not sleep at night because she is watching the child who gets sick. As the child goes to school, mother is the one preparing the provision. But on the other hand, the womb of a mother becomes a battlefield or war zone too, whose enemy is the defenseless unborn child. The enemies of this unborn child are abortion, artificial birth control, cigarette smoking, drinking hard liquor, and many more. That's why even the child still in the womb of a mother experiences rejection, insecurity, human rights violation, and lack of love from the parents. Unlike Mary, she follows God's will to be the mother of Jesus, even if she is in danger of being punished through stoning. Many women are not able to understand the meaning and dignity of motherhood. So, my dear friends, today let us pray for all the mothers, all the wonderful wombs that made us. Let us be grateful to them. My dear children, be thankful to your mothers. Without loving your mother, you cannot experience love of Mary. So today, at least, go to them, talk with them, sit with them sometimes, and at least eat with them if you could. At the end, let us reflect a story. A teacher had just given her primary grade class a science lesson on magnets. In the follow-up test, one question read, "My name starts with M and has 6 letters, and I pick up things, what am I?" She was a bit surprised to find half of the class answered the question with the word mother. So not magnet, mother is the 6-letter word, and she picks up not things, but we human beings. So my dear friends, today let us celebrate the solemnity of Mary, Mother of God, by celebrating our wonderful mothers who sacrificed their lives. A lot of mothers are not ready to sacrifice their lives. So, but our Catholic mothers are, I believe, very much sacrificial, and they spend their time, energy, whole life for their children. So let us especially pray for them. And I also pray for you all. As this is the eve of New Year, let us thank all our friends, family members in a very special way. I am grateful to all of you. Very specially, I am indebted to Pastor Mark McMahon, Father Kibbe, all the staff, and all the more to all of you, because you encourage me, you love me, and sometimes you reach out to me in my need. I am going back to India for my holidays in January 4, but you will be in my prayers. Father Jesuraj will help us with 6:30 Mass. I am also grateful to this wonderful priest. Whenever I call, he will reach out to help me and our church. So, my dear friends, let us experience the joy of being together and thank God Almighty for uniting us around this altar to share, to care, and to bear one another. I am concluding. May God Almighty bless all of you for all that you are and have been to me and all our priests and others. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Let us all stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father of Almighty. Dear brothers and sisters, as we have gathered here as one family, let us seek the mercy and blessings of our God by praying our intentions and needs.
That the church may seek to live more profoundly the good news of Jesus Christ, we pray to the Lord. That the religions of the world may seek to, together to draw nearer to God, we pray to the Lord. That those who are deprived of wealth and power may find their place in at humanity's table, we pray to the Lord. That the sick may enjoy God's blessing in abundance, we pray to the Lord. That we may come to know all people as our sisters and our brothers, we pray to the Lord. For Pope Emeritus Benedict, we pray to the Lord. For those intentions that we hold within our hearts, we pray to the Lord. That the dead may be welcomed into the company of Mary and all the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And special intentions for Andy Huddock, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, loving Father, we thank you and praise you for having accepted all our prayers and intentions. As we are entering the new year, be with us, guide us, lead us, protect us, and help us to be always in your love. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join us in singing number 481, Hail Mary, Gentlewoman, number 481.
Hail Mary.
Chosen for the sun, you
us wisdom, teach us love. There's a joy among women, blessed in turn, all women too. Blessed
and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to the fulfillment. Grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the solemnity of the Mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary. For by our overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praises as we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, Advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Mark our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your servant, Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy, be firm in protection in mind and body and your healing remedy. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Please join us in singing number 330, What Child Is This?, number 330.
Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church. Through Christ our Lord.
My dear friends, there is no announcement so far I know. If you need any announcement, please contact the office. This is a new thing, and you welcome that there is no announcement. So I would love to wish you all Happy New Year. Could you smile at all the pews and pass a wonderful message in this new year? Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
So may God bless all of you. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go and live with joy and happiness. Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing number 303, Joy to the World, number 303.